Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15.5 Beta 3 has been out for a few days. I've been using it full-time on my iPhone 13 Pro Max and iPad Pro, and wanted to share my overall experience with you, and your experience based off the YouTube community poll, where at the time of this video, there's over 8,400 votes and 70 comments. I've taken all of those comments, put them together to see what the overall experience of Beta 3 has been like compared to Beta 2, Beta 1, and iOS 15.4.1. So I wanted to talk about that, but before we talk about that, I wanted to mention one feature that I didn't mention in the initial What's New video. So there's actually an update to Photos, and it has to do with memories. So if I switch over to the iPhone 8 Plus here, you can see if I go into Photos and go to Memories, I have a memory of a nearby location of Charlotte, the city of Charlotte, and it just creates memories throughout the year with different photos that are significant and music and more. However, within the code of iOS 15.5 Beta 3, they've actually blocked locations that are sensitive, such as the Schindler Factory or the Anne Frank House or different camps around Germany and around Europe, and those sorts of things have been actually blocked from memories so that it doesn't create memories based off of those locations. We may see this change in the future with different locations as well, and they haven't said anything about this publicly, but those locations are actually blocked in memories, just specifically memories. You'll be able to, of course, see your photos and everything else. It just won't create happy memories of those places. Now, as far as anything else that's new, Apple this week actually updated AirTags, and we didn't know what was new in it, but then they recently released a support document that explains what's actually new in AirTag 1.0.301. So if you have an AirTag, what they've done is actually tune the overall sound of it to make it a little bit louder so it's easier to listen to or find if you lose it. So you can activate that, and unfortunately there's no easy way to update it. In fact, none of mine have updated yet. You can actually check that by going into your Find My app. So go into Find My, then go to Items, and within Items, tap on your AirTag, and at the top, I just have it scrolled up so you can't see it, tap on the overall location, and it will reveal the actual firmware version. None of mine have updated yet. It'll also show the serial number as well. So that hopefully will update very soon for everyone. Within the next couple of weeks, they just update on their own. Also, Apple announced their revenue this past week, and it was pretty impressive. It was another record-setting March, and except for iPads, everything was much, much better. That was due to some supply constraints that Apple expects to go well into 2022. So they said they made $50 billion on iPhone, $7.6 billion on iPad, $10.4 billion on Mac, and $19.8 billion on services. So a tremendous amount of money like normal, and that's what they made this time around. However, they do expect those supply constraints to go well into 2022. Now, as far as the overall experience of iOS 15.5 Beta 3, most people say that it's better than iOS 15.5 Beta 2 or 1, or even iOS 15.4.1. So that's a good sign. Also, another thing that seems to be working really well for me is AirDrop. So AirDrop before was a problem. If we go into Photos, if I AirDrop that to, say, the iPhone 8 Plus, tap on it, it's usually pretty fast. You'll see it worked right away, and then it's on the 8 Plus over here right away. So AirDrop works quick. It says that it says sent. Before it wasn't saying sent. Now it seems to be working 100% of the time for me. I'm also hearing good things about storage this time around, where if we go into General, then iPhone Storage, most people said that there were storage issues before, so we'll wait for that to load, and being that we're outside, let's turn off dark mode just because it's hard to see the display. You'll see that storage does take a little bit of time to load, but most people are saying that it's faster and that storage down at the bottom here, system data, is actually taking up less space for most people. So that's actually a really good sign. Before, it was taking up a lot of space for many people, and it seems like it's resolved for most now. You can see it's taking a while here. Let me run it on the 8 Plus and see if it does the same thing. So we'll go over to Settings, then General, then we'll go down to iPhone Storage, and let's see how long this takes as well. So we'll give it a moment and see what it does. So that loaded much faster, the initial load, and again, it's checking system data. So we'll give that a moment, and that loaded right away, 3.33 gigabytes on the iPhone 8 Plus. It should be something, at least a few gigabytes, but many people were saying that it could be as big as 50 gigabytes. So that's pretty unexpected. It seems like it's fixed with Beta 3. I haven't heard a negative report from anyone at all at this point. Now, cellular connectivity has actually been really good with this update. We did have a modem update in this version, and you'll see I'm on 5G UC. So I really haven't had any issues. I have two bars, and I'm kind of in the middle of nowhere. So let's go ahead and hit go and see what we get here. So we'll let it run just a moment here. Give it just a second. And It's pretty good, almost 300 megabits per second, and it's doing just fine. So 300 megabits per second down with just two bars. We'll wait for it to go to upload, and should do that any second here. There we go, and we're at about, well, only 3 to 5 megabits per second for upload so far. So nothing really great there, 5.73 megabytes or megabits, but it's pretty good overall considering I'm sort of in the middle of nowhere. But I haven't had any issues with it switching like I did before between UC or 5G and LTE. Now there are a few issues Apple still needs to fix in this update. One of them seems to be auto brightness. One issue I've had is when I go inside, all of a sudden auto brightness will bring the screen all the way down, and then you won't be able to see it. So that's a bit difficult, of course. If you're in a bright environment, you can't see your display. If you're in a dark environment, you can see it, but it's just very, very dim. So that's an issue for some people. I've seen that myself. And then also I had one person mention that they actually had it respring. So the phone just sort of restarted on its own and crashed. I only heard that from one person though. However, there's a very odd issue with iPad. So with the iPad, using the Apple Pencil doesn't seem to work at all if you have the Magic Keyboard attached. So you'll see it's not working at all, but if I take it off of the Magic Keyboard, we'll give it just a second here, and then we'll reconnect it, give it just a moment, it recognizes it, and now I can use it. However, if I put it back on the Magic Keyboard, there we go, take the Apple Pencil off, it doesn't work again. So even resetting it doesn't seem to work. This is an odd bug I'm only seeing on the Apple Pencil 2 and the iPad Pro. It's very strange with the Magic Keyboard, definitely a bug that we need to report if we haven't already in the feedback app. So wherever I have it here, feedback, we need to report that. Now there's also a duplicate app issue that showed up in beta 2 that's also showing in beta 3. So if we go into our settings, we'll get out of storage here, and if we tap on our name at the top and then go to iCloud, you'll see here it shows us our iCloud storage, and then you can see things like messages. You'll see messages here. If I scroll down below, you'll see messages repeated. So you'll see that with certain apps, for some reason they're repeated. Quite a few people are seeing this, and it looks like they're duplicated for certain apps. Not every app, but for some reason, some of them are duplicated, such as messages. So hopefully they'll resolve that. Again, if you're seeing that, make sure you report it in feedback so that Apple can take care of it and is aware of it. Also, as far as other issues, well, the only other major issue I'm hearing is that some people are still having overheating issues with their iPhone. I had this get a little bit warm, but I really haven't had any issues with it as far as it getting super hot. In fact, I would say it was less warm or not even close to what it was with beta 2. So beta 3 fixed that for me, but I am hearing that it's an issue for some people. Now, as far as overall battery life, let's go down to battery and battery health. I'm at 100% still, and I actually went into Coconut Battery to check this as well. I'll share that in just a moment, but I actually checked my battery health and it's still at 100% there as well. Now, my overall usage over the past few days, we'll take a look at yesterday. I had 3 hours and 4 minutes of screen on time, 9 hours and 10 minutes of screen off time. Now, I didn't leave music running, so I'm not sure why it's still having that music bug. That seems to be an ongoing issue where it's using additional background activity. The day before, 2 hours and 54 minutes of screen on time and 5 hours and 31 minutes of screen off time. Both of them used about 50% of my battery. However, when I went to bed at night, I was still around 50%. So it wasn't much of an issue for me with normal usage, but for some reason, it's a problem for some. Now, I wanted to share the overall battery life sent in by Abhishek. Some people send these in from time to time, and this is on an iPhone 11 Pro Max running beta 3. You can see he had 6 hours and 43 minutes of screen on time, 38 minutes of screen off time, and used about 75% of his battery. So it's pretty good battery life, probably not as good as a public version, but we'll have to wait for Apple to release the public version so we can see that later. Now, as far as Coconut Battery is concerned, like I said earlier, this is my battery health I measured there. It's at 100% with 127 cycles. You can see it shows the temperature was at 30.3 Celsius, and that's what this phone is at. Now my iPad is a different story. I measured it and it's actually gone down. It's at 91.8% capacity. This is again using Coconut Battery on a Mac. It's a free app, but it's not in the App Store. And it's had 156 cycles and it's about a year old. So that makes a lot of sense. Now my battery life overall on the iPad, again, is not really great. As far as battery life on the iPad, you can see here, if we go to the last 10 days, yesterday I had 1 hour and 45 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 14 minutes of screen off time. So it's not great, 3 hours and 32 minutes of screen on time the day before, and typically I'll get 5 to 6 hours of screen on time. So it's not really that great. And again, now that the battery's degraded a little bit, as expected, it's probably never going to get that 10 hours again, but it should at least get about 9 hours, and it's just not getting that. So hopefully Apple can increase this with an iOS update, or maybe it just needs a bigger battery at this point. Performance-wise, Beta 3 has actually been pretty good. So if we're going on the 8 Plus, and you can hear the birds in the background, they're a little bit noisy, but the iPhone 8 Plus seems to be nice and fast and smooth. The iPhone 12 Pro seems to be fine. It's working well. As also, if we go into the camera, it's nice and fast usually. If it responds to touch. This does have a screen protector on it, so that could have been the touch issue there. But you'll see it's nice and fast there, and no issues going back in. Go into the camera, and again, it's nice and fast. So no problems with speed or performance. I did run benchmarks so I could share those with you also. Now on my 13 Pro Max, you can see the single core is 1,732, multi-core is 4,677. I actually ran this twice because I found that to be a little bit low compared to before. So you can see the different scores here where we had, well, earlier today, it was a little bit lower. And then on the 26th, when it released, it was actually a little bit higher for the single core score, but lower for multi-core. It's staying in the general vicinity, 100 or so, plus or minus, is quite good. But let me share the other phones as well. And again, I'll read these for any of you that are visually impaired and have asked me to do that. So on the iPhone 8 Plus, it's 899 for single core, 2,329 for multi-core. On the 12 Pro, it's 1,589 for single core, 3,983 for multi-core. Now, when it comes to future versions of iOS, I was a bit surprised this week that we didn't have iOS 15.4.2. Usually when Apple stops signing an iOS version, such as iOS 15.4, meaning you can no longer downgrade to that version, typically we'll have an iOS update within 2 to 3 weeks. This was the third week and we haven't had an update. So if we go into the calendar, maybe we'll have one next week, but I'm just not going to count on it anymore as it seems like Apple may be waiting for iOS 15.5. However, we could always see an update to address security concerns like we had earlier in this week. There were some issues that were found as well as maybe some bug fixes and more before we get to iOS 16. I also would expect iOS 15.5 Beta 4 this week since we're on a weekly schedule. Between Beta 2 and Beta 3 was only a week, so I expect Beta 4 as soon as Tuesday this week, maybe Tuesday or Wednesday. Of course, Apple could change this, but typically once we get to a weekly cycle, we stay on the weekly cycle until the release candidate and then final version. Based off it already going to the weekly cycle, I would say the final version will be out before the end of May, and then iOS 16 Beta 1 will be on June 6th. Typically, we'll have iOS 15 and iOS 16 betas all the way until September, where mid-September we'll have the release of iOS 16 and then no more iOS 15 betas. That's typically what Apple does, but again, they can change this up. Maybe we'll only have iOS 16 betas, but either way, that's what they've done year over year. It makes sense that they would continue to do that. So that leads me to, should you install iOS 15.5 Beta 3 on your device? If you have the beta already, then definitely you probably already upgraded. But if you're trying to resolve issues, I would hold off maybe until Beta 4 or a final release where they resolve issues, especially on the iPad. So really at this point, I typically don't recommend betas unless you really are into beta testing and you have backups, then I would just skip it for now. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. And so I have them on my iPad that's right here. And we'll take a look at what Bob Jones said. Using the 15.5 beta, haven't used beta 1 or 2. It's very smooth and stable, and battery life seems to be just as good as the public version 15.4.1. Seems it's a little bit better also all around. I'll go as far as to say that the next build will be the final release. I would say probably a couple builds out, as the end of the build number isn't yet A. Usually once it hits the letter A on the build number, then we'll have a final release candidate and then a final version. Kevin said, 12 Pro Max on 15.5 Beta 3 switches from LTE, 5G, 5G UC, and Wi-Fi without interruption. Now fixed in Beta 3. Battery life is better than Beta 2. Also, I'm hearing that really no issues with Bluetooth this time around or Wi-Fi, so that's great news. Kim says, iPhone 11 Pro Max, iOS 15.5 Beta 3, running smooth or smooth running, no bugs, battery's good, iPhone storage downloaded instantly, all good, it's been 3 days. Colden Sauer says, is it worth it to participate in their public beta program? I'm rocking my first iOS device, iPhone 13 mini, and I always participated with my Android devices. I would say definitely if you have a backup, if you have maybe a computer, you can go back to a previous version if you have a problem, then definitely try it out. Otherwise, you might want to hold off at this point. Anton said iOS 15.5 Beta 3 is going great for me, no bugs, battery problems, or other issues. And also he said he's on the iPhone SE second generation. HalWG51 says, I'm using it on an iPhone SE 2. It is running fine and I have not seen any issues. When I first downloaded it, battery life seemed to take a hit, but now it seems to be back where it was originally. And that's what I'm seeing from most people. Typically, the battery life is quite good on this update. As good as 15.4.1 for most, not everyone. It really depends on the apps you're using. Headpack says, on iOS 15.4.1 with a 12 Pro Max, hoping for battery improvements. Endurance is not great, despite mine still being at 100% health. Seems with iOS 15.4, it took a nosedive. And this really depends on what you're using, what phone you're using, and how you're using it. Some people have great battery life. My daughters that use 15.4.1 and my wife really have no issues with it. Other people do, so it really just depends on what you're using it for and how you're using it. PNG Jeremiah said, on my 6S, battery life is better than Beta 2. It was the best on 15.4.1 though. So again, it really depends on which device you're on. Matt Mills said, 13 Pro Max, so far so good. Battery seems to be about the same as iOS 15.4.1 for me. And so I'm hearing a lot of the same thing from many people. It seems to be decent battery most of the time and fairly stable, with the exception of that odd bug with the Apple Pencil on iPadOS and a few odd bugs here and there. It definitely seems much better, and it really should be better this time around. Now, I would expect Beta 4 this coming week with maybe a final release in just a couple weeks from now. So if there's any other things you'd like to see in these follow-up videos, let me know in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.